Welcome to my latest video on learning technical and engineering English. Today what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through some of the tools that are used in engineering, and I'll tell you the tools in English with a little explanation of how they're used. So the first tool is a vernier caliper, and a vernier caliper is to measure internal and external sizes. And here you can see the internal and external calipers. External micrometer. The external or outside micrometer is to measure outside sizes or diameters. Internal micrometer. Engineers use the internal micrometer to measure inside diameters. Depth micrometer. Engineers use the depth gauge micrometer to measure depths or how deep something is. Dial gauge. A dial gauge is to measure distance. The measurement is on a clock called a dial. Height gauge. Height gauge is to measure the height of something, how high it is. It is also used to mark an object. Surface table. A surface table is a solid, flat table used as the main horizontal reference for precision measurement, marking or inspection. Steel ruler. Steel rulers are to measure distances or to rule straight lines. Engineer squares. An engineer square is to check a workpiece is square, that is that two sides are at 90 degrees to one another. Straight edge. Straight edge is to check that surfaces are straight. Scribing block. Scribing block is used to check flat surfaces and to find the centre of the round bars. Trammel or trammels. Engineers' trammel heads are for scribing arcs and circles. Protractor. Most protractors measure angles in degrees. A scriber. A scriber is a hand tool used in metalwork to mark lines on work pieces before you machine the piece. V-block. A V-block is to secure round or cylindrical items or work pieces. Parallels. Parallels are to support and accurately set jobs in a vise or bolted to the machine table. Angle plates. Angle plates are used to hold a workpiece for marking or measuring. Dividers. Dividers are used for scribing circles on metal, also used for measuring distances of markings. Center punch. A center punch is to make small points used as markers for drilling. Okay, so that's a list of some of the most used tools in engineering. Stay tuned because the video will now give you a multi-choice quiz so you can test to see what you've learned or can remember. So, welcome to Engineering Tools Part 1, Multiple Choice Quiz. This is where I'll show you a picture and ask you what the tool is. You'll have a choice of three. Before the answer is given, there is a short pause. But if you need more time, of course, pause the video. What's the name of this tool? Micrometer, vernier caliper, depth gauge. The answer is vernier caliper. What's this called? Dividers? Protractor, steel rule. The answer is a steel rule. What are these? Vernier calipers, trammels, dividers. The answer is trammels. What is this? Depth micrometer, external micrometer, internal micrometer. The answer is internal micrometer. What's this tool called? Dial gauge, depth gauge, height gauge. This, the answer is is dial gauge. What's this tool? Scribing block, height gauge, depth gauge. The answer is height gauge. What's this called? Surface table, square, straight edge. The answer is surface table. What's the name of this tool? Square, straight edge, steel ruler. The answer is square. What are these called? Straight edges, steel rulers, parallels. These are straight edges. What's this called? A height gauge, Trammel, scribing block. The answer is scribing block. What's this? Protractor, square, dividers. The answer is protractor. What's this tool? Center punch, protractor, scriber. The answer is scriber. What are these? V-blocks, parallels, angle plates. The answer is V-blocks. What are these? Angle plates, straight edges, parallels. These are parallels. What's this? Surface table, angle plate, V-block. The answer is angle plate. What's this? Dividers, scriber, protractor. The answer is dividers. This tool is scriber, dividers, center punch. The answer is center punch. That's the end of the quiz. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember, to do things again and again is the best way to learn and remember. So why not do the test again? Or watch the whole video again. Thanks for watching.